Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh, everyone. Welcome to episode 7, Moments with the Qur'an. SubhanAllah, almost a week of Ramadan has gone by. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala accept what has passed and bless what remains. Ameen. Today we take an ayah from Surah Al-Ma'idah, ayah number 8, in which Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, يَا أَيُّهَا الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا كُونُوا قَوَّامِينَ لِلَّهِ شُهَدَاءَ بِالْقِسْطَ وَلَا يَجْرِمَنَّكُمْ شَنَآنُ قَوْمٍ عَلَىٰ أَلَّا تَعْدِلُوا اِعْدِلُوا هُوَ أَقْرَبُ لِلتَّقْوَىٰ وَاتَّقُوا اللَّهَ إِنَّ اللَّهَ خَبِيرٌ بِمَا تَعْمَلُونَ. SubhanAllah, Allah in this ayah addresses the believers and He commands the believers towards standing upright persistently for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala witnesses injustice. Witnesses injustice. And then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala warns us against letting the hatred and enmity of a people towards us cause us to lack diligence with our testimony. We may witness something and our testimony is vital in terms of justice standing. But because through our testimony, we might support a person that hates us, it might cause us to swerve off the path of justice. It might cause us to lack diligence with the concept of justice. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala warns us. And Allah says, Allah is khabir. Allah is aware of the hidden matters. The matters in your heart, the matters in your mind that nobody knows. Right? Those matters that are motives behind why you do something and you don't do something. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is aware of all these things. Subhanallah. So here, brothers and sisters in Islam, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala lays down boundaries for us. That yes, people may act in a way that cause us to become upset, that even may cause us to dislike them. And if you dislike someone in your heart for reasons, then you're not accountable for this because this is human nature. But Allah will hold you accountable for what you do as a result of what you feel. It doesn't mean you feel something. So now everything you do is correct because you feel it. No, Islam governs what's right and what's wrong, irrespective of your feelings. So you might rightfully feel hurt because of the enmity of a people towards you. And we know this ayah came down when the Quraysh were big enemies and haters of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam and his message and their companions to the extent that they blocked them from the Kaaba. They blocked them from Masjid al-Haram. But despite this, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala commands the believers to be just. And this is from taqwa, as Allah tells us in this ayah. And we are in a month of taqwa, subhanallah. And in my training as a judge over 3 years in my master's program, subhanAllah, this ayah would come up time and time again in both the ethical side of judicial training as well as the fundamental side of our judicial training. It's such an important ayah and it constitutes an important value in several areas of our lives. But I want to take this further, brothers and sisters in Islam, and into a discussion related to the concept of wafa, and that is the concept of fulfillment, subhanAllah, whereby aside of testimony, right, we act in a way whereby we give everything and everyone their due, their haqq, their right, irrespective of what they do to us. Sometimes, subhanAllah, we may be friends with someone or have a good relationship with someone and they do amazing things and these things become a means for us. But then later on, one thing or the other happens and this enmity comes between us and them, or between them and us, right? And then subhanAllah, we move on with our lives and they move on with their lives. But does this mean we should now cancel out our memory of all the good things they did before this turbulence happened between us, right? Whereby subhanAllah, we might achieve something now and we've achieved it because of them being a means after Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Then when we achieve this something now, should we say, no, we're not going to thank them, we're not going to acknowledge them, we're not going to make dua for them, they deserve nothing because of their current behavior? Or should we say, subhanAllah, the current behavior is unfortunate, the current circumstance is unfortunate, but justice maintains that we give everything and everyone their right, and we have to acknowledge, subhanAllah, that these people, subhanAllah, were a means for us back then, irrespective of the situation now, but subhanAllah, then what they did, subhanAllah, has benefited me today. I need to make dua for them. I need to thank Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for what they did and ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to bless them. This is wafa, brothers and sisters in Islam. And it's a form of being diligent in terms of testifying to realities, right? All right, it's not related to the primary mandate of what testifying and providing a witness testimony means. Right? However, the subhanAllah, the Qur'an advises us to one thing, but the Qur'an's meanings are broad and it encompasses a plethora of different angles and meanings from them. This, brothers and sisters in Islam, this concept of wafa, this concept of being a person of fulfillment and giving everybody, you know, their due, subhanAllah, irrespective of what the circumstance and situation is. And we see the subhanAllah with the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. He loved his companions, but Abu Bakr had a status and he gave Abu Bakr his due for what Abu Bakr did. No one can be equal to Abu Bakr. He gave the people of Badr a status that others didn't have. Those who accepted Islam after Badr cannot be the same as those who accepted Islam before the battle of Badr. SubhanAllah. He gave everyone their haqq, their right, their due. This is a large topic, brothers and sisters in Islam, and our time has come to an end. However, the lesson is one of being just always, irrespective of people's circumstances towards us. And the lesson also is to be people of fulfillment, to give everything its haqq, its right, and its due, irrespective of people's behavior towards us, irrespective of circumstances. People may forget, but that doesn't mean we should forget. That is the sunnah of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, and this is closer to taqwa in a month that assists us towards the achieving of taqwa. I love you all for the sake of Allah. Until next time, salamu alaykum wa rahmatuhu wa barakatuh.